One more question, I can.
I saw recently, just now, Nancy Pelosi just tweeted that she will be running for minority leader. No. And I thought, I'd like to get your comments on what you think that will mean.
Susan, you better get back to work. Yeah.
I think Susan predicted this,
I would like to say. 2 hours ago, I came in and said, well, she's not going to run again, is she? And Susan said, no, I think she may well run for minority leader.
At first, we all wrote it off. We said, okay, she's going to lose 30 seats, and then why stick around? You know, if she loses 5 seats, then she can maybe be eyeing the next election as a chance to be speaker again. And it's much less likely that they'll be able to gain it back in 2012, which portends a longer stint as minority leader. Does she really want to go back to that? Well, apparently she does. She's 70 years old. She's just full of energy. This is a woman who reporters have to jog to keep up with, you know, in her stilettos running down the hall. You know, she's not, the idea that she was going to go back to San Francisco and get in her rocking chair and start knitting for the grandchildren, just, it didn't make sense. So, you know, she's a real fighter. She's a tough, tough lady. And actually, it's not really surprising that she'd want to stick around and be the minority. Because the minority, you know, they can do some things. And she's also a great fundraiser, so she's a real source of money and potential for Democrats to try to pick up more seats. And maybe she feels a sense of obligation, too, to try to get some of these seats back. But most importantly, the reason why she is going to run right now is that the caucus has totally changed. These elections wiped out their moderate faction, the very people who would have made it impossible for her to take over as the top Democrat. They're gone now. So what you're left with is a majority progressive caucus or a liberal caucus, and they love her. She passed health care reform for them. She got behind the cap and trade bill, the Lilly Ledbetter law. She got behind all these liberal causes that were really important for them. She was, in a way, their champion. So it's not surprising that she has enough support, and it's also not surprising that she would want to stick around and do it.
Yeah, Susan,
reactions?
Correct me if I'm
that's
wrong,
good,
but
that's interesting.
But I think most of the Democrats who came out during the campaign against her, like Bobby Bright in Alabama's one, and there were others, and most of them did lose, didn't they?
Right.
I mean, not for that reason.
And I'll tell you, in conversations I had with the Speaker's office before the election, they made a point of that, because people were saying, well, she will never have the support to stay around. And the point was made that the people that don't like her are probably not going to be in Congress. However, if they won by a slim majority, and the Democrats were still in control in the House, it would have been virtually impossible for her to maintain the speakership, because there would have been just enough moderates that would have voted against her, or someone would have assumed a candidacy for speaker, and she wouldn't have had the 218 on the floor, and the speakership would have gone to the Republicans. So you would have had someone like Steny Hoyer in that case. But Steny Hoyer will have to wait to get to become the top Democrat.
Steny Hoyer must really be having a bad day.
Well, this, what Susan described was the scenario that prompted Newt Gingrich's resignation from the speakership in 1998 November. And, you know, when he was under 218, he was out. But as Susan points out, Nancy Pelosi just needs a majority of the Democratic caucus. And, you know,
she's
California and the Progressive Caucus minus Jane Harman get you there.
Right.
And if you're a Republican campaigner, I mean, who was the single Democrat who was the biggest villain of all this time in these elections? And I think you could argue pretty easily that it was Nancy Pelosi. So I would imagine that the number of Republicans would not be at all unhappy to see that.
Yeah, we didn't see any Steny Hoyer ads around.
It's sort of amazing after this big, really, as we've described here, and Michael laid out on this really big election outcome, that the Republican Party will continue to be able to run against Reid and Pelosi. I don't think anyone would have quite predicted that. You know, people thought either Reid would lose his own race and or Pelosi would, the Democrats would lose the House, and that Pelosi would step down as Hastert did in 2006 when he was Speaker and the Republicans lost the House. So it is an irony, I suppose, that the Democratic leadership team will be the exact same team it was the day before Election Day.
Yeah, they're back, but there was a lot of collateral damage.
On that note, let me thank the panelists for an interesting discussion, and thank you all for coming.